Hello, and welcome on a new episode in today's analysis. Today, we are going to analyze none other than Winston Smith, the main protagonist of George Orwell's 1984. 1984 is regarded as one of the best fictional works ever made, and Winston Smith, maybe not as iconic as the Big Brother, could be easily being viewed as the earliest example of a civilian who indirectly came to challenge the totalitarian system he found himself in. In this video, I'm going to analyze all the information given about Winston Smith from both the 1949 novel and the 1984 film adaptation with the same name. Let's analyze Winston Smith's journey from a simple civilian doing what the party wanted him to do to an ultimate representative of hope that he has become. Now, with no further introduction, let's begin. Before I analyze Winston Smith, we first need to analyze how the world of 1984 came to be. Apparently, after World War II, the Soviet Union conquered the rest of Europe and became a totalitarian superstate known as Eurasia. While China and North Korea united together to form a new state, East Asia, which managed to conquer its neighbors. And because of this, both the United States and the British Empire united together to form a super country of their own called Oceania. Oceania at the beginning was a truly democratic, a more liberal nation that is the one we are seeing in 1984. Nevertheless, because of World War III, which put the world on the brink of extinction, the evil party known as the Ingsoc, ruled by the Big Brother, eventually came to power and turned the country into one-party fascist dictatorship that we've seen in the film, thus resulting in the world being shared between three super countries, all each one of them being totalitarian, as Oceania controlled the British Isles, North and South America, the southern half of Africa, and the oceanic countries such as Australia and New Zealand. While Eurasia controlled all of Europe, all the Soviet Union territory, and the northern half of Africa, as East Asia controlled almost everything from Japan to India. Nevertheless, each one of these countries being evil and totalitarian in their own way. With Oceania's ideology being English socialism, Eurasia's being Neo-Bolshevism, and East Asia's being the sacrifice of oneself. And here comes our protagonist, Winston Smith, a survivor of World War III, in which he lost both his mother and sister, and now works for the party, specifically as the Minister of Truth, helping to fake history, to help the party to maintain its grip on power by making the people to believe certain events from the past were true while others were not. Winston Smith eventually lived his life in solitude, and sometimes even wrote his thoughts into a journal, something that many will see it as rebellion in his current society. Nevertheless, Winston Smith came to indirectly challenge the party by doing the one thing that the party didn't want him to do, to fall in love, as a woman named Julia eventually managed to fall in love with him, and both of them together started a relationship in secret, away from the eyes of the public. Unfortunately for Winston, the party managed to find out about their relationship, and O'Brien captured him and his girlfriend and tortured them and brainwashed them with the intention to eventually kill them. Here, O'Brien revealed to Winston the truth about Big Brother, being nothing more but an invention made by the party in order to justify their grip on power, and used it in order to keep control over the innocent civilians, over the masses in general, including to the control they once had on Winston Smith and Julia. Here, Winston Smith was brainwashed by O'Brien into believing to the party's propaganda and all the lies that they tell to the people, eventually resulting in his unfortunate execution, along with Julia's, of course. But nevertheless, although the 1984 doesn't have a very happy ending, it does offer somewhat hope to the people, as given the fact that it took the party so long to find out about them, and had to do all of this to brainwash one person, actually presents a potential for hope, as there is an actual hope that resistance could rise against the Big Brother. So in the end, who was Winston Smith? He was nothing more but an innocent man who desired to find a place for himself in the world, a man that would desire to find love and home into a totalitarian society that doesn't care at all about his people, a man that would indirectly come to challenge the system that he found himself in by just falling in love, and a man that could be revealed as one of the best representatives of hope across all kinds of fiction. Thank you all for playing this new episode in today's analysis. I hope you all guys enjoyed. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Have a nice day.
No one escapes, Winston. There are no martyrs here.